Welcome to another edition of Trade Talk TV. Today we've got Matthew from Webarama. Matthew, thanks for coming in today.
Morning.
And today we're talking about the anatomy of a DMP and how it works with the strategy around data, particularly with the advertisers. And it has become a huge part of their overall sort of media buying strategy. Matthew's here today to talk about this. So Matthew, give us an idea of what Webarama do, just overview, and then we can just jump straight into it.
Sure. So we work around data and specifically to help advertisers and publishers optimize media investment using data for about 15 years. We've done that in a number of different ways with different business models, and one of our latest developments has been an integration of our different technology solutions into a single stack, where we do ad serving, cross-channel tracking, attribution, data management, media buying through DSP, so really an integration around data for our clients. And the data management module of that is effectively a DMP. It's called Webarama Audience Manager, and it becomes more and more the center of the Webarama stack, because that's really where you centralize all of your customer knowledge, all of your performance data, and where you make it actionable.
Okay, let's map that set then. In terms of, I'd like to know, you know, lots of talk about DMP and its importance and in the sort of ad stack now. But how does it integrate with the overall data strategy of an advertiser? Where does it fit in? Sure. How does it work?
So when we approach a DMP project with one of our clients, there are really three layers that we're looking at.
Yeah.
So Webarama Audience Manager is the name of our platform.
So wow. Bring me out there.
Wow, absolutely no reference to George Michael or anything
George
like that. No skinny shorts or anything like that. Don't get any ideas. So the first thing we're going to look at and we're going to work on is data collection.
Okay.
Then there will be segmentation layer. And the last part, but maybe the most important one, is the activation piece. Okay, so those are really the three building blocks of a DMP and a DMP strategy. So when you start to think about DMP, well, first you need to stop to think about your data strategy, right? And when you come to the point where you say, okay, I need to have something, I need to have a tool where I can centralize and really applicate that strategy, you need to start thinking about your data collection. What type of data do you want to have into the DMP? In our view, there are four types of data that can be used into a DMP. There's everything that relates to your sites or your apps, right? So that's the data that your users will create when they navigate on your site, when they browse your product, when they use your mobile app. So anything around time spent on the site, page viewed, you know, sections of the sites, recency of visit, frequency of visit, all of those things can be used as data points into the DMP. Then you will have all of your media data. So basically your interaction with your clients and your prospect outside of your site. When you run a display campaign, when you're in a search campaign, affiliates, there are data points between your brand and your users that happen outside of your site. All of that can be centralized as well and used to create segments of users that have been exposed, that have engaged, looked at your videos, clicked on your keywords in Google, and stuff like that. Then there's your CRM data, obviously. CRM is a major point of interest because there's been huge investments in CRM. And right now, advertisers are only able to monetize those investments through direct marketing, which is very limited. Right? With a DMP, you can actually activate CRM data in the wider media world.
Okay. What, like have to segment it and then execute against it in a media-buying fashion?
Well, we'll look at that in segmentation. But basically, you know a lot of things about your clients, but you're not using it when you run a display campaign, right? Mm-hmm. What if you knew that somebody who's going to see your ad is a client and not a prospect? You can potentially serve them a different banner. If you know they are a high-value client or a client at risk, you might also serve them different messages, right? So all of that CRM, that customer intelligence data, can be activated through a DMP.
Okay.
So that's very much what we would call first-party data. So that's data that belongs to the site, to the advertiser, sorry.
Yeah.
And then you will have partner data, which can be called second-party data in some cases, which is basically data that the advertiser will pull from a partner. Let's take a concrete example. We're working with an insurance company, and they have partnerships with car websites. They sell auto insurance,
right?
And they have partnership with car websites.
Right.
So in this case, second-partner data will be data that comes from those websites and that the insurance company want to pull to be able to identify interest in buying a new car. Because for them, it's a major moment for marketing their auto insurance products.
So
that would be second partner data.
So just give us sort of a snapshot. It would be cookie data, or would it be sort of like a landing page where you have like a car and they're all looking for information? Is it they pull data from that, or is it
data pulled from that partner?
Yeah.
Usually from one of their properties, so one of their website, one of their app, and that will be of interest to the advertiser because it will show something from a marketing standpoint. So typically, a user browsing a secondhand car of a certain type on this website and going to the comparison page, for instance, will have an interest in buying a new car. And that interest can be registered into the DMP and used by the insurance company to then target this user with specific auto insurance offers.
Okay.
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 So that's the collection, data collection landscape, let's say, right? The different types of data that you can pull together into the DMP. At this stage, you are going to structure that data. So you're going to define the attributes, the criteria that will be used in the segmentation phase. So it's a very, very important phase. And usually when we start a project, there's between a month and 3 months rollout of the platform.
Yeah.
A good 2 weeks are dedicated to putting together data strategy and data collection strategy for the clients. So making sure this is clear, and this is very important, that's the input into the DMP. If the input's not correct, there's no chances the output will be right. Once you've built this collection layer, you have basically one ID per user and a set of criteria attached to those ID, right? And this ID can be played with into the segmentation layer. So the segmentation layer, what's particular with the WebRama DMP is that we're using, obviously, the WebRama database, which is a huge database of marketing profiles that we've built in a number of countries, giving us anywhere between 50 to 80% reach on users of a given country with demographics, intent, behavior, household income, et cetera, et cetera. So a lot of characteristics that you can pull from to improve your segmentation. Just starting from first-party data segmentation capabilities, once all of that has been defined, you can say, I want to create a segment of clients to whom I could upsell a car insurance product, for instance.
Yeah.
I'm an insurer. I have home insurance clients, right? Clients that have a home insurance contract, and I want to upsell them to my auto insurance product. So I'm going to say, okay, let's take all of my home insurance clients, right?
Mm-hmm.
And let's combine that with user who have expressed an interest in buying a new car, mm-hmm. right? Either because they've been to a partner website and they are an auto site visitor,
mm-hmm.
or because they have browsed my auto insurance section on my website, right? So auto insurance section. So what you can do in the segmentation layer is combine those criteria to build an audience, to build a segment, right? So you're going to say, I want to take all of my clients and find the intersection between my clients and visitors to this website or visitors to my auto insurance section. So you can do and, or you can exclude, right? And I want to exclude all of the clients that are already clients of my auto insurance product, for instance.
Can you build, like, obviously this is all done maybe as per campaign, but can you build rules in here that allow you to pull this information together and have pre-made sort of segments effectively?
Well, there are two ways to do the segments. So that's the first one is to do it manually. The second one is to do it automatically.
Yeah.
I'll take you through that
okay.
in a second. But from a manual standpoint, it's really you say, I want to target those type of people,
mm-hmm.
and you replicate this definition into the DMP by combining criteria to create your audience. It can be first-party data, second-party data, it can either be a third-party data as well. You can pull information from here saying, and I only want ABC ones, right? Because I want to sell them the expensive stuff. So I only want to take users that have a certain level of,
yeah.
of income, right? So you can build all of that, combine them, exclude your current clients, really create a custom segment, and save that as an audience. And once you've done this, the audience exists physically. There's a list of IDs that corresponds to those criteria. And this list of ID will be updated continuously as new users go to your partner website or as new clients are pushed from your CRM system. So that's the first way to create an audience, to create a segment. The second way is to do it automatically using lookalike modeling in particular.
Okay.
Right? So when you want to do, when you want to improve your prospecting activity, you can either say, well, I'm sure my target audience is this and that, and you do this, or you want to say, well, let's look at people who have bought my product or my services, and let's try to find other people that look just like them. That's what we call lookalike modeling. In WebAROM Audience Manager, we've built something called C-Clones, which is basically a lookalike modeling application. So it's an interface in which you say, okay, I want to take converters to this specific page, right? Mm-hmm. So people who've come and bought for more than 100 euros of product on my website over the past 7 days. I want to find people who have the same attributes to those users and who are more likely than average to convert. So basically, you use the WebAROM database to find lookalikes, right? So you have maybe like 1,000 people here, and you want to find 1 million that look just like them. And that will be your prospect segment. So here, you will trust the math to try to find out how to reach the most performing users within the overall population.
Yeah.
So basically, those are the two types of segmentation that you can work from. Either what we call audience builder, which is very much an interface in which you check boxes,
mm-hmm.
or C-Clones, which is an automated audience modeling application.
Yeah.
Once you've created those segments, then you can activate them.
So this is obviously your database for all the historical information regarding audience profiles, demographics, etc. And then you pull this type of this data here, whether it's conversion data or whatever, into this decision engine or whatever it does. Crunches the numbers and then it spits out the lookalike model.
Exactly.
Segments.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
Okay.
It lists all the users that look like the one who bought your stuff in the past X days, and put them together into a high propensity to target to convert segment.
And then once that's done, how do you activate?
And then you need to make it activable, right?
Yeah.
So you need to make them usable because until then it sits in a database and you can't do anything with it, right? So activation is actually making that information available. So synchronizing it with the rest of the ecosystem so that you can actually find those users.
Yeah.
So there are a number of channels that you can use DMP to optimize your strategy. The first one is display. Just standard traditional guaranteed display, right? It's pass that information to your ad server.
Or your DSP.
Just ad server, traditional standard stuff, right? Let the ad server know that the user is either a prospect or a client,
mm-hmm.
right? So when you serve an ad on the homepage of Yahoo,
mm-hmm.
well, you're not going to serve the same ad if it's already a client or if it's a prospect.
Mm-hmm.
If it's somebody that will be interested in your prepaid cell phone product or in your smartphone subscription, monthly subscription product, right? Different types of users, different segments,
mm-hmm.
different messaging,
mm-hmm.
right? So start by optimizing your traditional display or affiliate strategy.
Yeah.
Right. So that's the first one. Second one is RTB. Obviously, RTB has been built to use data,
mm-hmm.
right? So activate or make those segments available in your DSP so that you will have targeted buys for a certain type of people, right? With the associated messaging.
Mm-hmm.
That's easy. We do that through server-side synchronization with most DSPs.
Yeah.
It's a matter of minutes between the time you create this and the time it's available here.
Yeah.
Right? Then there's search.
Okay.
It's a bit of it's not totally organized yet, but there are ways to optimize your SEM activity using segments coming from a DMP.
Oh,
from a DMP. Yeah. So you can have different bidding strategies, you can have different messages, right? Into Google and Bing,
mm-hmm.
using a remarketing list, for instance. So again, it's not very well industrialized. There's a lot of unknown about what will Google allow us to do and not.
Okay.
But at this stage, it's something that can be done at some point.
So there could be, you could theoretically optimize your SEM campaigns using this information in terms of
if you know that they are
text,
users is a high value prospect, you might want to bid more. than if it's already a client, for instance.
Of course, Google being diffident about this.
Well, let's say it's not very much. It's not very industrial yet, right? So there are a lot of discussions around those lines. So display RTB search. You've already optimized a good chunk of your media investment, right? Then there's everything that relates to your site. Because your site is usually the first point of contact between you and your brand and your users, right? And you want to be able to adapt the content of your site,
absolutely,
either through CMS or through self-promotion management tools. Using segments, right? If you know that someone that comes to your site is already, to go back to my insurance example or earlier, an auto insurance client, and that their contract expires in a month, maybe you want to give them a special message, right? That would be different from the message you would give to someone that is not a client, but someone that is a home insurance client. So optimizing your site is also one way to activate data from the DMP.
So then you can basically obviously improve site performance as well by optimizing the
content.
As per what they were interested in previously.
Absolutely.
Interesting.
And the last one is direct marketing.
Okay.
You can, with some client, we've built email retargeting scenarios, right? So scenarios to address users who belong to a certain segment with a certain email message, right? So using data that is already available into the CRM system of the client, just trigger emailing strategies using DMP segments.
Okay. I think we're sort of running out of time, but I'll just finish on one last question then. There's been a lot of hoo-ha around this whole GDNP where you can't fire a third-party pixel, but if you're registered, unless you have an ad server, but that doesn't affect you because you have an ad server.
Well, basically, all the media data that is collected here is collected through the web, can be collected through the web or ad server, in which case it does not apply to the limitations that Google has expressed, because we are a certified ad server to serve on Google properties. So we are able to pull information from our client to serve campaign and use that information to build audience segments.
So that doesn't affect you in any way?
No.
Okay. All right, Matthew, thanks for that overview. Great overview of collection, segmentation and activation around the DMP, and we look forward to seeing your CEO speak at ATS Paris, and thank you again, and
thank you.
We'll see you next week. That was True Talk TV. Thank you.